Well, the warm-up will get underway now, and that is how the start of this floor exercise will pan out. Dmitry Patanin getting us underway, the athlete from Kazakhstan, with the dubious honour, I think, of going first. It must be quite a daunting prospect to be the very first athlete out onto the floor. But of course, he then sets the standard. And he can just then relax and watch the rest of the competitors, knowing that he's done his best and his routine is done and there's nothing more that he can do. Of course, these athletes will get warmed up before we get the competition underway. Well, the leader among these athletes is Ihor Sheremku, which is really quite astonishing considering his 50 points came from just two World Cups. And after winning the floor exercise in Baku, another high quality performance will put him over the top. Benjamin Osberger, that athlete you just saw there, the Frenchman, alongside Aral Benovic of Croatia and Brazil's Yuri Himaraj, as well as Diogo's Escobar of Cuba. They are all still in the race as well. So this is really going to be quite an intriguing floor final, because those Olympic qualification spots are absolutely wide open. That is the French athlete, Benjamin Osberger, a very exciting young prospect indeed, and how much would he love to be representing France at his home games.
And this gymnast marks the end of your warm-up.
Well, Dmitry Patanin, the athlete from Kazakhstan, will be getting us underway. He's one of four Kazakhstanis competing in Doha over the course of this weekend. He took silver on the floor at the Asian Championships in Singapore last year. And he finished third in qualification.
We're waiting for the green light for the first finalist.
Well, he had the highest execution score of any of these finalists with 8.3.
Number one on floor exercise is an athlete from
towards the lower end of the scale with a 5.9. It was that execution that really helped his cause, dragging him into the third spot in qualification. Let's see how he does here. He had a disappointing campaign and Kotbus didn't make the final of any of the disciplines in which he entered. That was the horizontal bar, floor and parallel bars. Finished fourth on the floor in Cairo. So Cairo was where he was at his best. He looks pleased with that performance as well. He should cleanly done, confident out on the floor from Dmitry Patanin of Kazakhstan.
Dmitry Patanin is 23 years old, member of a club in Astana.
very clean.
It's not the first time that we've seen
tumbling
in
passes.
The final of four exercise this season.
Shaped nicely throughout the air, stuck his landings. That is a very good start indeed. And we know that this is going to be a very high quality floor final.
The four exercise final, Dmitry Papanin of Kazakhstan. Let's wait for the first score of today.
So as you heard that from the stadium announcer, we are waiting for the first score of today. Dmitry Papanin, the 23-year-old from Kazakhstan. Getting us underway here in Doha. Certainly much improved from his showing at Cottbus. He did look confident. Which was half the battle, really. Was his score in qualification. 14.533 was the highest score in qualification. He wasn't too far off that. You can see there, Paris 2024 Olympic Games qualifying event really is unmissable. These athletes know exactly what's at stake in Doha. Of course, the pressure is on in any competition. It is magnified tenfold in Doha. Well, he looks relaxed anyway while he's waiting for his scores. The judges are normally very quick to tot everything up, but for the athlete waiting, it must be a very long wait indeed. Just look at that, 5.9 for the difficulty, 8.6 for his execution, which is an improvement on qualification.
Is a gymnast from Brazil.
So a very pleasing start for Dmitry Papanin.
Yuri Guimarães.
Dmitry Guimarães finished in qualification in fifth spot, 5.9 for his difficulty, just as we saw from Papanin. 8.2 for execution. He is still in with a chance for a place at the Olympic Games. Old from Sao Paulo. He already has a host of medals to his name from international competition. He was part of the bronze medal winning team at the Pan American Games in Santiago in November. And at that same competition, he took silver on the floor. Or rather, at the Pan American Championships, he took silver on the floor and the gold on the vault. So he had a very good 2023 indeed, hitting the right form with the Olympic Games on the horizon. Well, big cheers going up around the arena. And he applauds the crowd for their support. Turns 21 at the end of July, when the Olympic Games will be on, and what a celebration that would be for him to be spending his 21st birthday representing his nation at the Olympic Games.
If I'm not mistaken, it's the first time that we see him in the final of a World Cup. He has been in the final of some World Challenge Cups on floor exercise in Croatia, in Paris. But
as you heard from the stadium announcer there, this is the first time we're seeing Guimarães in the final of a World Cup. So if he's not mistaken, and I can confirm that he is not mistaken, this is the first final at this level for this athlete.
Let's watch some of the replays of that exercise.
He was 10th in qualification in Cairo, just missing out on a place in that final. He also contested the vault in Cairo, finished 41st in qualification. So the floor is certainly where he's most comfortable, where his strengths lie. He has, of course, competed at World Challenge Cups. We saw him in Croatia last year finishing 7th in the final on the floor. But certainly he is an athlete who is improving.
And there's the score, I think, yes indeed, 13.933 for Yuri Juraj of Brazil.
Slightly down on his qualification.
And here is Kazakhstan again.
Penalty has cost him, but Dmitry Patin set such a high standard to start off the competition. Another athlete from Kazakhstan next up. He was the strongest in qualifying. This routine has a difficulty score of 6.3. And his execution was good in qualifying. 8.233. Second highest execution of all the finalists, apart from Dmitry Patanin. This gymnast is a serial World Cup medalist, and you can see why. Such an elegant gymnast. He took a bronze medal last year in Antwerp at the World Championships on the floor. This is very much where he feels at home. Represented Kazakhstan, of course, in the Tokyo 2020 Games, and how much would he love to make it to back-to-back Olympics.
Milat Skarini, Olympic finalist. Floor exercise in Tokyo in 2021, not only on floor exercise but also in the all-around competition. Two Olympic finals for him 3 years ago.
Now the stadium announcer is giving Tokyo you all the information you need to know. Two-time Olympic finalist both on floor and in the all-around competition in Tokyo 2020, so he has got experience on the big events. He knows what it takes to get there.
Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate that. I see a flag of Kazakhstan there. That's really cool. Let's wait for the score of that exercise of Milat Karimi.
In this final with a 14.5, we saw there on those replays that Karimi sometimes struggling to hold a shake. He recovered well on the landings, but he is into the lead. 14.766, his execution score way up from qualification. And Karimi takes the lead from Dmitry Patanin. This is France's Benjamin Osberger. 7th best in qualification. A really exciting young athlete for France. Still in contention for that Olympic spot at his home games. Generally, his difficulty scores aren't that high, but execution-wise, he is excellent. He was 4th on the floor at the World Championships in Liverpool. It was his debut at the World Championships, and what a result that was for him. very clean in his form, generally finds the ground really well in his landings. Really can be quite remarkable. He's had a couple of fourths in World Cups this year. How much would he love to get on the podium, especially in Doha, given what's at stake with those Paris spots still to play for. Huge support for him in Doha. Relieved almost to have got that routine finished. I suspect that nerves will be quite high amongst many of these gymnasts here, especially the younger ones, especially the ones who haven't yet secured their Paris spots. Off centre there on his landings. Normally his landings are very clean. He has won a medal on floor in the World Cup before. He knows what it takes to get onto that podium. He is a really exciting young gymnast indeed.
Not too far away from the German and the Swiss borders. And he's kind of a specialist on floor exercise, Benjamin Osberger.
Seventh on the floor in Cottbus earlier this year, fifth in Cairo, and then last year in Baku finished fourth in Cottbus in 23 as well. He's always there or thereabouts, but he's an improving athlete. He's young and he has a very, very bright future indeed.
And there's the score, I believe, yes, 13.733 for Benjamin Osberger of France.
Well, that result puts the Frenchman into fourth place. Fourth of four. Certainly not his best performance, but did look a little nervy out there on the floor. And there are the standings as things are at the moment at the halfway stage of the men's floor final. It's the two Kazakhstani athletes who are leading the charge. Karimi and Patanin. And then Yuri Kimarish of Brazil is currently occupying that third place. And of course, for the athletes who are competing a little later in the final, they have the benefit of watching the athletes who go before them, knowing the standard that's been set. And they know what they have to do. They know what they need to do to get onto that podium. Whereas for the athletes who go first to set the standard, they might occupy a podium place, but they know that there are people coming behind them who can knock them off. That is Luke Whitehouse, Great Britain. He won gold his major championship debut in Antalya at the European Championships in 2023, following in the esteemed footsteps of Max Whitlock, Christian Thomas and Dominic Cunningham, becoming Britain's third European champion on that piece of apparatus. And then at the age of just 19, he pulled off a world first at the World Challenge Cup event in Croatia. He became the first known gymnast in the world to complete a triple back somersault. He's now in his third senior, third year as a senior gymnast. 2022 is his senior debut, reaching the World Cup final. He was also selected as a reserve for the Commonwealth Games in Birmingham that same year. He made his major championship debut at the Europeans. And was part of the British men's team that claimed bronze on the first day of competition. Huge hike in the air, and what a landing. So two really remarkable landings. He had the big step forward at the end of the second tumbling pass. Off-centre during that tumbling pass, but the landing didn't suffer. You can see he's growing in confidence as this routine goes on. Smile across the face of Luke Whitehouse, certainly looks satisfied with that performance. Second best in qualification with a difficulty score of 6.5. The execution let him down in qualification, 7.9. But the difficulty was a big score. A 14.766 is the score to beat. Milad Kerimi of Kazakhstan currently on top of the podium.
Luke Whitehouse, let's wait for his score.
Fantastic to see the camaraderie, the fraternity amongst these athletes from different countries, congratulating each other, supporting one another. It is good to see that level of support, that level of respect among these athletes. Big step forward. I think that was the only landing he didn't seem to stick throughout this routine. Still, Milad Kerimi, who is on top of the podium as things stand. Now, this gymnast, Benovic Erel of Croatia, finished fourth in qualification.
Here is Erel Benovic.
He got silver on the floor in Cairo last year at the World Cup. Took bronze at this event in 2022, didn't make the final in 23. But he is a European silver medalist. He has 3 World Cup gold medals, 2 silver, and the bronze. And one of those golds was from his home World Challenge Cup event in Osijek in Croatia in 2002. So he is no stranger to that podium. Benovic is a 23-year-old athlete. At the age of 19, when he was still a teenager, he won his first major medal. He won a silver on the floor at the Europeans in Mersin in Turkey that year. And look at the smile, that says it all, doesn't it? Well, fourth in qualifying, has he done enough to go one better? Getting himself on that podium.
Did you see that smile on his
Looks
face
like he thinks so.
Oh,
the celebration, the smile, big hug from the coach.
Was born in the city of Osijek in Croatia. He won the bronze medal here in Doha in 2022 on floor exercise. He's an absolute floor specialist. It's no coincidence that we see him in the final here today. Arnold Benovic of Croatia.
It's always interesting to see an athlete's reaction as soon as they finish the job. What is their initial reaction? And his was joy. He pumped his fist, he had the big smile, he clearly thinks he's done well. And who's better to judge that than the athlete? So it'll be fascinating to see how the judges award these points to see whether or not Benovic has done enough to get onto the podium. Coach seemed to think so. As did the athlete.
There it is.
Not quite. Fourth place. For Benovic. So these are all high scoring routines in deep competition for those podium places is absolutely fierce. Very high quality final indeed.
The ball exercise.
Nicholas Cherry of Cyprus is next up, sixth in qualification, just shy of 14 points. His execution was high, he scored an 18.2 there. His difficulty is a 5.7. His best result in any World Cup competition was seventh in Cairo last year. Final there. Hasn't made too much of an impact since. Although he did compete at the World Championships in Antwerp. Last year didn't make it past qualification. He competed in Cottbus and in Cairo this year at the World Cup events at this level. Didn't make the final. This is the first final he's made this year. So he is showing improvement.
Lovely on the screen, on the big screen here.
Well, one final athlete to go in this men's event. After Aziz Nurliyev of Uzbekistan is the final athlete to go. And score to beat 14.766. Well, Nurliyev is unlikely to beat that one, finishing in eighth in qualification. The lowest difficulty score. 13.433. That is slightly down on his qualification score of 13.9, quite significantly down, in fact. Puts him into seventh place, which is the same. One spot below, rather, what he achieved in qualification. Well, this is our final floor gymnast, and this gymnast also finished in eighth place in qualification, as you can see there. Well, his execution was very good. He got an 8.2 in qualification, but it's that difficulty score that pulled the overall score down. Nurliyev finished 18th in floor qualification at this event last year, so this is a huge improvement for him from last year, having made the final. In fact, this is the first World Cup final he's made this year. He's slightly out of bounds there with his right foot. Saw there as he struggled to find his balance on the landing. It looked almost as if he sort of let out a big sigh of frustration. It's important that he doesn't, you know, let things like that put him off balance, upset him, and just needs to remain confident throughout the rest of the routine. Final athlete to go on the floor. Nurliyev of Tashkent in Uzbekistan looks almost relieved to have got that done, but he needs to be proud of the way he's improved from last year. He finished 18th in qualification then, only to finish in the final this year, so that is a job well done indeed for the athlete from Uzbekistan. Looked a little bit nervous at points during the event, and that is understandable if you're competing in a final, you're finding yourself at that level. And that concludes the first final of the day, the men's floor. Still four more fantastic events for us to get stuck into throughout the rest of the day. It is Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan, who is on the top spot of the podium, and I'm sure he will remain there after the judges give their score for this routine. Two Kazakhstan athletes currently occupying first and second spots on that podium. Into the White House of Great Britain in third. Kazakhstan guaranteed at least one medal. Finishes one spot higher than he did in qualification, so there's a job well done for the Uzbeki athlete, but it is the two Kazakhstanis who take gold and silver for Luke Whitehouse of Great Britain, or a silver rather for Luke Whitehouse of Great Britain, and a bronze for Kazakhstan. Not much in it, 14.566 for Whitehouse for the silver, and Patanin with 14.5 for the bronze. Karimi taking gold.
In just a couple of moments, ladies and gentlemen, the second final of the day.
Well, this men's floor was one of the more open finals in terms of those Olympic qualification spots. The medalists for the men's floor are in position, ready to receive their awards. It seems like a long time ago now that we saw the floor final here in Doha. It was a fantastic way to start the day's events. Well, Dmitry Patanin was the first athlete to go. He picks up the bronze medal with a score of 14.50. It was a very closely contested floor final. Luke Whitehouse picking up the silver for Great Britain with a score of 14.566. So 0.066 the difference between bronze and silver. Gold medal goes the way of Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan. Performance that scored him a 14.766.
What a fantastic podium. Time for some pictures with these amazing athletes. The podium of the men's final on floor exercise.
Has been one of the most closely fought contests for Olympic qualification. Two-time world medalist and Cairo champion Ahmad Abu Al-Sud of Jordan is guaranteed a ticket to Paris. That second spot is still up in the air. It's between Naraman Kurbanov of Kazakhstan and Li Chi Tsai, Tokyo 2020 silver medalist, Chinese Taipei. So this is going to be a very closely fought, tense final indeed.
Yeah. are almost ready for the first exercise in this four horse final.
First to go. Martin Lodinian. 13.9 years of age. Of Armenia. He is a Pommel horse specialist and a two-time European champion from 2016 and 2022. He's also a two-time world championship bronze medalist. He got those medals in 2015 and in 2022. His gold medal in 2016 was the first artistic gymnastics continental gold for his country. So we've seen Oksana Chusovitina on vault, still competing at the age of 48. Well, this man continue competing into his fifth decade as well. He'll be 40 in August. It's a great inspiration to the youngsters to see these athletes still continuing to compete.
Would you believe me if I want to tell you that he is 39 years old? Would you believe me? And gymnastics, he was the first student from Romania to win gold medal at the European Championships.
Careers ahead of them. Well, that is up on his qualification score of 14.6. So I'm sure that he will be that one.
Let's go.
It's difficult to go first and set the standard. Reese McLennan finished fourth in the qualification with a 14.966. He is a back-to-back world champion on this apparatus. He defended his world championship title on Pommel Horse in Antwerp in Belgium last year at the World Championships. And that sealed his Olympic qualification. He competed at the Tokyo Games. He finished in seventh place in the final. I'm sure that he will be hopeful bettering that performance in Paris later on in the summer. Slight nod of the head. The world champion. two medals. And this apparatus, silver in Birmingham in 22 and gold in 2018.
Two-times world champion Rhys McLennan, he won the golds last year in Belgium in Antwerp, and the year before in Liverpool. He knows what it is to be on the podium at the major event.
He's spoken openly about overcoming the mental challenges on his path to success. Opened up about his fear of failure, about panic attacks, about not wanting to compete at times. He says he takes comfort in them, he's not alone, that other athletes feel those things as well. Gymnastics is an unforgiving sport. Anything can and often does go wrong. Flanagan says he recognises that these insecurities, so just be part of the stresses and challenges of everyday life. So he says he's worked hard to overcome those insecurities that he has. Qualification score 14.66.
And an athlete from Chinese Taipei. Here is Li Shikai.
And here comes the strongest qualifier with a score of 15.40. He wants to be at the Paris Olympics. He is in with a chance. Silver medal at the Tokyo Games. Silver medal at World Championships in Stuttgart and the separators in 2019. And a two-time gold medalist at the Asian Games on this event. Back-to-back Asian Games titles from 2018 to France to 2022 in Hangzhou. And there is a fantastic reaction from the athletes in Chinese Taipei on a job well done. Fantastic to see these athletes applauding themselves, applauding a good performance, enjoying the gymnastics out there.
And we will get the score of Li Shikai.
So,
watching a replay of his landing.
by the reaction. He's confident on the spot.
And there's the score, 15.4.
Nariman Kurbanov is next up. Finished second qualification, as you can see there. Very high score. He is in contention also for an Olympic spot. Silver medal position, bronze medal rather, position in Hangzhou at the Asian Games behind the athlete who we've just seen. He is the current Asian champion on this apparatus. Those are the standings at the halfway stage of the Pommel Horse final. In terms of the athletes to follow, I think it's likely that those standings will change. We have Ahmed Al-Soud of Jordan. Still to come, he's guaranteed a spot in Paris. Those athletes who finished highest in qualification have already competed for the exception of Xiao Yuan of Chinese Taipei. He will be the final athlete to compete in this apparatus. Medalist on this apparatus from the Southeast Asian Games. Won that medal in Hanoi in 2022. This is his specialist apparatus. Watanabe says that the Vietnamese gymnast says that this nation could win medals at the 2028 Summer Games in Los Angeles with the right preparation and support. And that is a shame to see. He has 30 seconds to get himself back on the horse. Just centering himself again, chalking up his hands. Is ready to go again, just settling his nerves a little before he resumes. Everything seemed to be going well in the routine until that point at which he came off the pommel horse. Well, we wouldn't necessarily have expected him to be in those podium positions anyway, having finished 6th best in qualification. Nevertheless, it's never good to see an athlete coming off the apparatus, and for the athlete it's never good not to be able to complete the routine properly. Jordan, make some noise. That is the instruction from the stadium announcer, because next up it is Ahmad Abu Al Soud. Well, no surprises there for the Vietnamese athlete. Ahmad Abu Al Soud, 5th best in qualification, the first gymnast from Jordan to win a medal at the World Gymnastics Championships when he won silver on this apparatus in 2022. He then went on to win a bronze on the pommel horse at the 2023 World Championships. And he's also a 2-time Asian champion on this apparatus, 2019 and 2022. So incredibly accomplished on the pommel horse. He's guaranteed his spot in Paris. He'll be at the Olympics, but who will be joining him? That's the question. And a big smile. Rami, 28-year-old from Jordan, satisfied with his performance, a nice clean routine, confidently executed. Big congratulations from his team, from his coaches. Great support from here for him. Results at World Cups this year that means he's been able to qualify for those Paris Games. And he doesn't need to be here in Doha having already qualified, but he's here of course because he wants the competition, he wants to remain competition fit. He'll want a World Cup medal as well. 15.40 is the score to beat. That is the best score so far, and that was Li Qizai. Will he have done enough to get himself on the podium, judging by his reaction? He thinks so. It's what the judges think that's important. That score is huge. And just look at the reaction from Ahmed Abu Al-Soud. He's got his Olympic qualification anyway, and now he is guaranteed a medal in Doha. Just two more athletes to go. Abu Al-Soud will be on that podium. 15.5 is the highest score so far in qualification or in the final. Well, what a performance to follow for Benjamin Osberger of France. We saw him earlier competing on the floor. He was seventh in qualifying with a 14.7. He was fourth in Cairo on this apparatus earlier this year, fourth in Munich at the European Championships in the summer of 2022, but he hasn't managed to make it onto the podium just yet on the pommel horse. Can he change that here? Well, he needs to beat some big scores if he's going to do that. He needs to be in the 15s. Rhys McLenehan is currently occupying third spot on the podium with a 15.233. An assured performance from the young Frenchman. His face expressionless, he's giving nothing away. Some of these athletes are very expressive, you know exactly what they're thinking. We saw there Abu Al-Soud, big smiles, big celebrations between himself and the other Jordanians, but Osberger is completely expressionless. Athlete. an improvement, though, on his qualification. So I'm sure that he will be satisfied with that. He wouldn't have expected to get himself on the podium. Xiao Juyan is our penultimate athlete. Third strongest in qualifying with a 15.0. But he'll need to do better than that if he is to make the podium in this high-scoring final. He's not alone. Second athlete to come off the horse in this final. Disappointing performance from Li, the 28-year-old from Yilan. He's a very accomplished gymnast indeed. Silver medalist at the Tokyo Olympic Games. Xiao Yujian, that is a disappointing performance for him. Li, of course, is on the podium in second place as things stand. Xiao Yujian will be disappointed with coming off the apparatus. He was part of the bronze medal winning team at the Asian Games in Hangzhou last October. He was fourth in the Pommel Horse final at those games, and he has competed at the Tokyo Games representing Chinese Taipei, too, as well as his compatriot Li Qizai, who was the silver medalist then. Await the judges' scores for Xiao Yujian, the final athlete to go in this Pommel Horse final. He won't be knocking Ahmed Abu Asud off that top spot. He is currently in the gold medal position, 5.5 his score, followed by Li Qizai, 15.4, and Reese McClenahan with a 15.233, an incredibly high-scoring Pommel Horse final indeed. Of course, a pivotal result for Li Qizai. 0.66. At least Xiao Yujian doesn't look upset by it. Big smile between him and his coach, and it's a result that he was expecting. Well, there are the final standings for the Pommel Horse final. It's the Jordanian athlete Ahmad Abu Al-Sud who takes the gold, followed by Li Qizai of Chinese Taipei and Reese McLennan, the back-to-back world champion, taking the bronze. but Abu El Soud and McLennan have already claimed their Paris spots. Well, this is another final where the Olympic spots are still very much up in the air. And here's the start list. It will be Nikita Simonov who starts us off. He is in the mix for an Olympic spot. Samir outside of France. He's incredibly close to heading to his home games. He's France's most experienced hopeful, and he's been the most consistent through the qualifying events. He will need another big performance here today if he is to get across the finish line in the top two and seal his spot in Paris. Nikita Simonov, he's a threat. Vahan Davtyan of Armenia and Arthur Avetsyan, also of Armenia, they all pose threats. Ryong Yong-il was the champion in Cairo. He started this World Cup series very strongly. He then faded, but he too, he is in contention. If he were to win here and the others didn't improve their positions, and Omar Mohamed of Egypt, he could still technically win a place as well. So this still rings final. It's going to be a very tense and intriguing one. Certainly not straightforward in terms of those Olympic qualifications places. But of course, no matter what happens in Doha, I would urge you to check the website of the International Gymnastics Federation, where all results will be confirmed, as well as those Olympic qualifying spots. That is where you will get the official confirmation of results, as well as confirmation as to who will be on that plane to Paris. Who will be watching from home? Well, the strongest qualifier was Armenia's Vahan Davtyan, one of two Armenians in this final. Two Egyptians as well. These two nations well represented. It will be Nikita Simonov who gets us underway. The Azerbaijani athlete actually won gold on the steel rings in Kotbus. Can he add to that medal tally? Fourth in qualification. Can he go one better here and get himself on that podium? His routine has a high difficulty score, 6.2. Remarkable landing, a wonderful reaction. It really was a masterclass from the Armenian, who took bronze in this event last year in Doha. Gold in Baku the same year, gold in Cairo. Disappointing in Cairo this year, finishing in sixth, but does have a gold medal from Kotbus to make up for it.
the gold medalist of the World Cup.
Nikita Simonov makes a strong start to the Still Rings final. He knows what's at stake here. Eight is the score to beat. Simonov setting the pace up on his score from qualification, 14.733. Slight improvement from there. It is now the turn of Jong Il of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, 33 years of age. Took gold in Cairo, fifth in Cottbus. A very strong start to the campaign, faded then slightly. Needs a strong showing if he is to get himself an Olympic berth. He finished seventh in qualification. But he also finished seventh in qualification in Cairo and then went on to claim gold in the final. Back on landing. Other than that, it was a confident routine from the 33-year-old. Six, not quite enough to match the score set by Simonov at the top of the table. And down on his qualification score as well. Arta Avetsian is one of two Armenians in this final. European silver medalist on rings. Universiade gold medalist on rings. And he has two Cottbus bronze medals to his name as well. Second strongest in qualification. finish fourth on this apparatus in Cottbus. He finished fourth in Cairo as well. Will he go one better and get himself onto the podium in Doha? Nicely done, clean on landing. Reaction at all from Avestian. A 14.466 is enough to get him into second place. As things stand, as soon as he got his result, he was up and away. Slightly down on his qualification score. Nevertheless, a pretty solid performance from the Armenian, but will it be enough to keep him on those podium places? Samir Aitsaid, France's most experienced Olympic hopeful. He is this close to sealing his spot at his home games. It would mean so much to him. He broke his leg vaulting during qualification at the Euro 2016 Olympics. How much would it mean to him if he were to seal a spot in Paris and put that previous Olympic nightmare behind him? Won a total of three medals, one in each colour, on the rings, the European Championships. He didn't make the Tokyo Games. If there's one Olympics that he wants to be at, it will be Paris. Just listen to the reaction from the Frenchman. He knows that Olympic spot is up for grabs. He wants it, and he has done his very best to get his ticket to Paris. Huge reaction from the Frenchman. Did make the Tokyo Olympic Games, finishing fourth, just off the podium positions. Podium finish here would very much put him in contention to make his third Olympic Games his home games. Of course, all these scores are subject to final confirmation from the International Gymnastics Federation. You can find all of those on the website. Will be announced in due course. You suspect that Samir Aitsaid will be on that plane to Paris. third in qualification with a 14.533. Wonderful to see an athlete expressing themselves like that for a job well done. It's fantastic to see them celebrating their success. Of course, plenty of celebration and support in the crowd as well. 14.466, 14.8 rather, is the score to beat. Not quite. 14.633 gets Samir outside into second place. That is the halfway stage of this final event of the day. Those are the standings. It's Nikita Simonov of Azerbaijan who leads the way. Francis Samir outside in second. Of course, that is all subject to change. Still four more athletes to compete on these still rings. And the athlete who scored highest in qualification, Bhagnat Davtian, is still to go. He scored a 14.733. If he matches that, that will be enough to get him into the silver medal position. Comes from a gymnastics family. Davtian, a very familiar name on the FIG circuit, the older brother of Olympic medalist Arta Davtian. He's a three-time European medalist on this apparatus. Contrast between the athlete we last saw and Davtian. Of course, the Frenchman celebrating wildly at the end of his routine, Davtian giving absolutely nothing away. Impossible to judge how he feels that routine went, as there was no mistaking how Samir outside felt after his performance on the rings. Is another athlete who is in contention for one of those Olympic berths.
He is a ring specialist, Davtian, 35 years old. This is Omar Khatoum.
Picked up a silver medal in Cairo, a bronze in Cottbus. Didn't have anything. No points from Baku. This really is a pivotal event for him. Score. 14.833. He sneaks into the lead by the finest of margins. Simonov knocked off top spot with his 14.8. Davtian sneaking in with a 14.833. Absolutely expressionless as his result comes in. Egypt's Ali Zahran up next. his best result this year, has actually come here. This is the first final he's qualified for. Fifth strongest in qualification. He's one of two Egyptians in this final. He didn't make the finals in Cairo or in Cottbus. He did last year, but has had a dip in form in 2024. He is the 2018 African champion on this apparatus. Celebration for Zaran. Certainly enjoyed himself out there. Why wouldn't he want to make the most of this moment, his first World Cup final that he's appeared in this year? He wants to soak up the atmosphere, the adulation. He's celebrating with his teammates. I'm sure there will be more celebrations to come, because there is another Egyptian gymnast still to go in this final, Omar Mohamed, who is in contention with the spot in the Olympic Games. Score of 14.466, not enough to challenge for a podium position, but it is up on his qualification result. An ultimate athlete is Vincenz Hook of Salzburg in Austria, fifth best in qualifying. Is a silver medalist from the European Championships, took the silver in Mersin in Turkey on this apparatus. Also took silver at the Summer Universiade in Naples 5 years ago. He's now 28 years of age. See him making the final time and time again. He's not usually one you'd expect to be in contention for those medals, but nonetheless he is a consistent finalist at World Cup level.
final in Koppers, finishing 8th. Didn't make the final in Cairo. He did pick up a bronze medal in Baku in 2023.
Hook from his qualification score, but not enough to get him a medal. He's not teaching for an Olympic place, but this man is Omar Mohamed of Egypt. He still could technically qualify for the Paris Olympics, but it will take a huge performance here from him. Already, he's qualified for the Tokyo Games. Didn't get past the qualification round. Nonetheless, has had a taste of the Olympic experience, and no doubt would love to go back for more. He's a former all-round African champion. Of continental medals all around on floor, the vault, the parallel bars, and of course on the still ring. So he's a very useful all-rounder, certainly one you'd want to have in your team if you're competing in the team event. He's definitely capable of picking up some decent results across a number of different disciplines. Mohamed, the final athlete to perform on the steel rings, the final athlete to perform today, and the score of 14.033 will not be enough to book himself a spot at the Paris Olympics. It's not enough for a podium position here in Doha either. Incredibly, it is Van Tavdian who takes the gold, just sneaking in there ahead of Nikita Simonov, who set the early pace. He was the first athlete to perform. He was a long-time leader until Davtian, who was fifth athlete to go, knocked him off his spot by the finest of margins. Samir Ait Said of France will pick up the bronze medal. A decent performance from Vincent Hook, who we're used to seeing in these finals, who tends to be towards the bottom end of the table. So a good, solid performance from the Austrian as well.
Four, three.
Lisa McClanahan. Ireland's back-to-back world champion steps up to receive his bronze medal, a score of 15.233 in the final, earning him the bronze. We will of course be seeing him at the Paris Olympic Games, where I'm sure he'll be hopeful of adding to his already considerable medal haul. This is Li Jinzai of Chinese Taipei picking up the silver medal with a score of 15.400, and the gold. Goes to Jordan's Ahmad Abu Al Sud. He scored a 15.5, so another closely contested final. Not much to choose between gold, silver, and bronze, but it's Ahmad Abu Al Sud who's top of the podium for Jordan.
Time for some pictures of these athletes. Gentlemen, congratulations, thank you so much.
To the gymnasts who competed on the steel rings. And that was a really fun final for this man, Samir Eid Said, who had the biggest celebration of all of these gymnasts today. He really enjoyed himself out there on the field of play. And he's rightly celebrating a hard-won bronze medal. Nikita Simonov was the long-time leader in this contest. He set the standard. He was the first athlete to perform, set the standard with a 14.8. And he led until the fifth athlete, not the final, stepped up to the rings. And that was this man, Bahan Davtian, who just snuck the gold with a 14.833, so it was another incredibly closely fought final. 14.833 for gold, 14.8 for silver, and 14.633 for bronze. Davtian, the slight smile on his face, that's a rare sight. He's normally very composed, expressionless. Celebrating the gold. congratulations to all three medalists, Davtian Simonov, and Aitside. Bronze for France. Silver for Azerbaijan, and Armenia with the gold.
With France, with Azerbaijan.